So recently someone asked this question. They said, "Chris, is wholesaling real estate dead?" And I thought, you know what? That's actually a great question. I'm going to bring on the resident expert that has a network all around the country with I don't know how many thousands of people dishing up and finding incredible deals. And I actually want to know, is the trend going down? Is the trend going up? What is happening right now in today's market? So you've probably seen a lot of videos out there and a lot of suggestions online that say wholesaling can be crazy lucrative. Spend very little time, make massive amounts of money. And right now what I want to do is I want to dissect this a little. I just want to ask you, based on your experience and all the deals that you've set up, I mean, first of all, how big is your network?
Well, I'm doing deals all across the country now. And so any market in the US, as long as there's a deal that fits my criteria, I'm all over it.
Okay, so you're doing deals everywhere and you've been in this wholesaling game for about 15 years, right?
Yeah, about 15 years.
So based on what's happening in the economy, what's happening with wholesaling? First of all, is it thriving and alive? Is it dying? Is it too much competition? Is it not enough?
Well, let's be honest. I mean, there's the upside and the downside. Because we're in a seller's market right now, the market trends are good. What that means is it means there's more people that want houses than are available to buy. Mm. Okay, and that's everything from homeowners all the way up to Wall Street money. Everybody wants to put their money into real estate, meaning that getting a deal, buying a good deal, is kind of tough right now. Think about it. I mean, how many people do you know that go out there to try to buy a home and there's multiple offers, it goes for over asking price? So people say to me, "Jerry, there's no deals. There's no deals. Wholesaling is dead because there's no deals." Now, let's just set that aside for a second. And the flip side is, if and when you get that good deal, you can actually wholesale it for more than you've ever been able to in the past. You can make more money on a wholesale deal than you ever could in the entire 15 years that I've been doing this.
You know, Jerry, I just got to say, I get questions all the time like, is it a good time to buy real estate or not because the market's doing this or that? Or when's the market going to crash? Or is wholesaling dying? And there's a significant portion of the real estate market that is filled with skeptics and people that, because they're inexperienced and because they don't know, they listen to everyone else that
says,
it's not possible, you can't do it. And I just want to ask, are people wholesaling in this market?
Oh my gosh, wholesaling is happening day in and day out. If somebody says to you, wholesaling doesn't work, or they say to you, there's no deals, what you need to do is you say, oh, so you don't know how to find deals. Because that's really what it is.
Okay, well, what about flipping? Because people are also out there saying the exact same thing. They're like, oh, you can't make money flipping.
Oh my gosh. So check this out. I just looked at this. Adam Systems, or Adam Services, they're the number one data aggregator in the country. Last quarter, they reported that flipping, gross flipping, is at the highest that it's been at. It's like 69,500 than the entire 18 years that they've been doing that study. It's higher than it's ever been. Flipping.
Okay, so flipping's all-time high, but what about, you can't find any good deals in the market because the market is only going up and up, so there's not enough good deals out there. Is that true?
Yeah, well, here's the thing. It is harder to find deals. So what that means is it means you just need to put more focus and energy into finding those good deals. Look for ways that you can become an expert at finding deals. That's like 90% of the game. Once you do that, everything else is easy.
And I think that's what this conversation really comes down to, is that anyone that pushes himself to become an expert never has a problem. We're talking about the layman. We're talking about the lamos. We're talking about the people that are brand new in the game, and their mindset just washes them out because you'll hear, oh, you can't find good deals. You can't find undervalued real estate. You can't make flips work in this market. There is no wholesaling opportunities. That will always be true for those that are kind of on the weaker spectrum of just being inexperienced, untrained. They don't have the tools that or the softwares. They don't have the classical training that will make the difference.
And you have to adapt. You know, if you're going to do real estate in today's market, then you've got to change the way that we do things, right? I don't know if you remember this, but I mean, you were buying then. In 2008, 2009, 2010, I could go out any day of the week and buy a property without even trying. There was like foreclosures everywhere and short sales. It was easy.
Yeah.
Now, it's just different. It's not good or bad, it's just different.
Well, and we've been through both market cycles. You know what happens when the market is in its dip, and we know what it's like when it's in its bubble, and it goes dip, bubble, dip, bubble,
just how
dip,
goes.
Bubble. And so what's interesting is if you actually look at the market cycle, when the real estate market falls out, all the consumers are terrified of real estate, but it is actually the very best time to buy. Then when the market is in its bubble, everyone's trying to get into real estate, and you gotta figure out how to have a strong enough mindset that says, I'm not gonna allow my mindset to be driven by population because the market is driven by consumer confidence. So when consumer confidence is weak and they're all running in one direction, guess what a true investor does? they adapts. Run in the opposite yeah. direction. And when all the consumers are running in this direction and everyone and their dog wants to become an investor, mm-hmm. guess what the investors are doing? They're doing something different. There's always an angle, there's always an edge, there's always a way to get in the game, but you have to first start by believing it. This is a mindset question.
It really is.
This is why I actually have people, you know, they'll go to chriskrohn.com, they'll go to my website, and every quarter I put on a huge event where people from all over YouTube come join me, and I put on a 3-day transformational mindset event. And these events are at a life-changing status. My event coming up, we've got a firewalk planned. I mean, they're incredible because we're here to get the mindset corrected. If you want to succeed, though, there's really two things that you're going to need. You're always going to need top-notch mentoring, and then you're always going to need the mindset. So I always offer my mindset trainings that people can come to, and my YouTubers get to come at discounted rates, which is really cool. But on the other hand, there's people that are looking for the tools and the softwares and the system. And Jerry, you've got some tools that have really been helping a lot of people.
Big time.
Tell us a little bit about what they can do. So instead of wondering if wholesaling is profitable, you can just show them how to get to the deals, how to evaluate them, and how to get paid 10 grand maximum from what the market's normally paying.
That's right. So imagine being able to shortcut and get right to the deals. So that's what we've done. We've developed a software. What it does is you put your zip code in and it will give you a list of all of the properties for sale that are underpriced. They're below market value. So you know right which ones to go after. I mean, it just saves you so much time and effort and it gets you right to the deals. And we're offering this software. We're giving it to you for free.
Friends, there's so much that's out there. You got to decide first what you really want. Is wholesaling dead? No. Far from it. It is actually at peak profitability, just like flipping, just like most anything else that's happening in the game of real estate. And I'll tell you that when the market bottoms out, we'll be saying the exact same thing. Because with the right training, the right mentors, the right tools, and the right mindset, there's nothing you can't do. I know because we've done real estate in all parts of the cycle. And even in 2008, when we had our biggest drop-off since the Great Depression, guess what? It still worked. The systems are out there. We were crushing it. So friends, go out there, get the right mindset, and crush it. And if you want some help and you want some of the tools on how to actually make wholesaling maximum profitability, because it's at a maximum profitability right now than ever before, click the link in the description below and sign up for a brief online training that will actually walk you through exactly what that looks like and have Jerry cut you a $10,000 check on finding your next big deal.